We're going to have our beautiful friend Adriana, who's one of the organizers of this and many other things, to give us an acknowledgement of country, because we are in the beautiful land of the Aboriginal people. And Adriana's going to take it from here.
Thank you, James. Just a couple of things before we go into the acknowledgement of country. Just administrative things. First of all, this concert would not have been possible without the support of so many volunteers, performers, technicians, and so forth, and the support, wide support of the community. It's been sold out. We're so grateful. It is part of many activities that the team Assange Sydney has organized towards the appeal of Julian in the UK on the 20th and 21st of February. So this is one of the events marking that appeal and wishing Julian all the best. It is a tough time for him, but we are wishing him from here all the best. Thank you. I would like to acknowledge the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, who are the traditional custodians of the land we meet today, of the forests, the rivers, the hills, and the lakes nearby. I would like to pay my respects to all elders, past and present, and to the children of today, who are the elders of the future. We acknowledge that this land has never been ceded. This is, and always will be, Aboriginal land. Thank you.
Thanks, Adriana. She does a lot of work, you know, as does the Chilean community for Julian. And, you know, they've suffered and they know what suffering is. A big hand, you know, the Chilean community are so supportive of anyone who's struggling in this world. And we know there's so many struggling. So thank you, Adriana, for that. Thank you. And thank you to the Chilean people who are present here. Okay, our first artist is Jasmine Beth. Now, she plays original songs about problem people. I'm sure we've got a few problem people here. Looking around the room, there's a couple of people out there. I know definitely got problems. Gamblers, for example, she talks about, and politicians, which are a perennial problem. Her main influence are the folk and country of songwriters from the 60s and 70s, and she spends a lot of time touring Australia and the UK. Her single Gambling Man was a finalist in the Great American Song Contest of 2021 and commended another major songwriting contest. Can we all welcome, please, the beautiful Jasmine Beth. Thank you.
Thank you very much, James. And thanks to all of you for being here tonight. When I was trying to decide what I would sing tonight, I thought I'm going to sing mainly about what we're all here for and what we want, and that is Julian's freedom.
Yeah.
And we want that freedom immediately, and we want it unconditionally. So I'm going to start off with a song by Bob Marley called Redemption Song, and he wrote this inspired by a speech made by Marcus Garvey, who was a very renowned Jamaican political activist. Oh, pirates, yes, they rob us, stole us from the merchant ship. Minutes after they took us from the bottomless pit, but my hand, it was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? They're all I ever had. Redemption songs, these songs of freedom. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy. none of them can stop the time. How long will they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just part of it, you got to fulfill the book. But won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? They're all I ever had. Redemption songs, these songs of freedom. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy. None of them can stop the tide. How long will they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just part of it, you got to fulfill the book. But won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? They're all I ever have. Redemption songs. These songs of freedom. These songs of freedom. Let me sing one.
Closer to my guitar. And now this next song is one I wrote about Julian. This is the first time I played it in public. And it's a song I wrote based on two songs that came before it. The first one's a song called I Dreamed I Saw Joe Hill Last Night. Joe Hill was a very famous Labour activist who fought tirelessly for workers' rights and then was, as is known, framed for a murder and executed. And he inspired a song by Bob Dylan called I Dreamed I Saw St. Augustine. And this one's a song I wrote, it's called I Dreamed I Saw Assange Last Night.
I dreamed I saw Assange last night, free as you or me. Stella standing by his side and his children at his knee. Gazing at the clear blue sky, breathing in the cool fresh air. They might have jailed my body, he said, but my mind, it was never theirs. Stand up, he said so loud in a voice unrepeated. Remember what I showed to you, so it may not be repeated. A million dead civilians in the Iraq war. While our governments assured us nobody was keeping score. Dreamed I saw Assange last night, free as a bird on the wing. And I dreamed that I'd stayed silent while he was in Belmarsh prison. My heart was cold, my tongue it froze, my hands were still as clay. And I watched helpless as the dead as they took my freedoms away. I dreamed I saw Assange last night, free as you or me. Stella standing by his side and his children at his knee. Gazing at the clear blue sky, breathing in the cool fresh air. They might have jailed my body, he said, but my mind, it was never there.
Mentioned that was also the third inspiration for that was a speech that Stella Assange gave at the National Press Club last year. It was a very moving speech, and she talked about when she imagined Julian free, she imagined him free in the way he was growing up, which was, you know, running amok in the Australian countryside in Victoria. And this last song I'm going to do is my last one for the set. Is a song by Bob Dylan. I invite you all to sing along with me, whichever part of it you know, all the verse, all the chorus.
Say every man needs protection. Yet every man must fall. I swear I see my reflection. Someplace so high above the wall. I see my light come shining. From the west down to the east. Any day now, any way now, joy and shall be released. They say everything can be replaced. Yet every distance is not near. So I remember every face of every man who put me here. Shall be released. Way down there in Belmarsh prison, there's a man who's clearly not to blame. All day long we're crying out, shouting out that he's been framed. I see my light go shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any way now, Julian shall be released. I see my light go shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any way now, Julian shall be released. Thank you.
Thanks very much. I'm now going to invite Ralph Graham, a wonderful singer-songwriter. He's going to get up and recite a quick original poem.
Thank you, Jasmine. What about a big extra hand for Jasmine and her heartfelt stuff there? I'm not exactly going to recite it. I've got a cheat sheet here. But it's just a very short poem, and I've been put in at the last minute, and I do appreciate that. I'm honoured to be here. I just want to say, before I say this little poem, that I don't have the balls, the grit, the nerve to be a full-blown whistleblower. It takes a special person to risk their freedom, possibly their lives, to help us have freedom of speech outside the jail. I won't say any more, I'm getting emotional. All right, blow the whistle loud. Sometimes when we look, we see just what we're told. We look, but look below the surface. Don't wait till we are old. The future generations, they may not just forgive. Don't bow to corporations and never deign to live in fear of our own power, of our own destiny. It's we the people power the right of you and me to stand, beseech our servants who govern for a day, to serve us, but will rule us if we just look away. Never fear to question, to blow the whistle loud. Our energetic righteousness will see us standing proud. Without the fiery weapons, just strength and ceaseless pride, we'll stand up and be counted with what we feel inside. The heroes of our time will break the petty laws. The times they are a-changing. Step up and be the cause. With chains they try to bind us and keep us under thumb. Let's put it all behind us. And we need everyone. We must not sell our freedom. Too precious, not for sale. We're joining hands together, and together we'll prevail.
Very nice, very nice. Together we'll prevail. Well, this next band we've got is very exciting. I remember when I arrived here as an 18-year-old, bright-eyed, bushy-tailed in Australia, got off the plane, and there were wonderful, wonderful musicians around, and we've got one of them, well, more than one of them here, but we've certainly got one from the original Whoopee band. I remember thinking, gee, that's a really weird name for the time. But he's here, Mick Conway and the Bees. Mick Conway. Oh, so some of you are old enough to remember. I was going to point out that maybe some of you might, but I certainly do. They were a wonderful, wonderful innovation, very different, and gave Australia a place in the world. And Australia has been a rock and roll country for a long time, and it's been denied us by poker machines, and can't blame anyone else. Anyone thinking of anyone else? Anyway, we've got a lot of problems here. And the poker machines are one of them. Get rid of them. Get the musicals back. Anyway, the songwriter, he does fire right, eating tap dancing. I'm actually stepping on the tap dancing thing here. And no fire, yeah. So, you know, you can take off your asbestos shirts. There'll be no fire. I'm sure he wants to hear about this. He says two record albums reaching gold status, gold. Yeah. And he has toured the world working theatre, television and films. But his two compadres here, since 2020, have been living next to him in Katoomba. Imagine that must be like living next to a legend in Katoomba. And one of them is from Berlin. And they say of themselves, they're Mike's neighbours, leading a tantalising Teutonic tutelage to mix musical mayhem. Yeah, so if you can, I can't believe I got my mouth around that. I'm probably in the way here, so I might just back off. I Mick's trying to, you know, coax me into the bed or something. You know,
lovely.
Yeah, that's as close as I've come to love for a long time. No, seriously, mate. You know. Okay, I'll leave you to the wonderful Mick Conway and the Bees. Thank you.
Thanks, we're just going to fuss around for a little while. At least I am. I'm still getting it. And I'm going to start off with a song dedicated to Albert Einstein, who wrote Time is Relative, and I have relatives doing time. Okay. What about Julian Assange? Okay, here we go. This is, time is relative, or reality is an illusion. Some sense of this chaos and confusion. Don't stress, reality is an illusion. Don't strain your brain, you'll go insane to find everyday solutions. Do not fret, do not stress, reality is an illusion. The world's running through space, half a pace per second, but we're standing still just the same. A straight line is part of a circle, reality invention of the brain. Your world is upside down, madness all around, despair and delusion. Do not fret, do not stress, reality is an illusion. Machine. Your world is upside down, madness all around, despair and delusion. Do not fret, do not stress, reality is an illusion. Reality is an illusion. Reality is an illusion. Thank you, fellow reality. Please. Ah, yes, you know, a song about getting old. The older you get, the better you were. Remember that? And when I was young, I had long hair and I took acid and I hung around hip joints. Now I long for my hair and I take antacid and I'm hanging out for a new hip joint. But here's something really important to say. When you get to a certain stage in life, a certain critical junction, when you get to a certain age in life, things start to malfunction. Your list of ailments begin to grow, your reflexes, they start to slow. But you know what's the worst thing to go. I got the short-term memory loss blues. The short-term memory loss blues. I can't remember anything. The short-term memory loss blues. I got the short-term. Whatever. Now where the hell I put my keys, and where the hell I put my keys. The short-term memory loss blues. Although I must go far down the road, the Hume Highway.
Hume Highway.
And trucks will pass, and gummies fall. Oh sorry, that's the wrong song with the wrong bridge. It's a different song altogether, sorry. I got the short-term memory loss blues. Be glad that you're not in my shoes. It's a bugger when you're memory shot. I sing the rest, but I forgot. The short-term, don't tell me. The short-term, I'll think of it in a second. The short-term memory loss blues. Thank you, if you can remember. I don't know if any of you remember the Captain Matchbox Whoopee Band.
Yes.
I certainly don't. I was too stoned at the time, but I can remember. I'll try and remember this song. And it's one of those old songs that made me what I am today, a broken down old hippie. It's about giving drugs to your pets, which your parents and grandparents used to do, to make them sing. My direction.
One, two, three.
Extra, extra, read all about them. You can pray there if you choose, just to show the times have changed a lot. Though it may sound strange to you, it is absolutely true. You can believe it or not. Since Meg and Whoopi became on the grudge, it's even gone into the old bird cage. My canary house circles on his arm, on his eyes. He used to whistle a prisoner's song, now he just thinks the whole day long. My poor canary heart circles on his arm. His only pals are the meadowlark and just a tiny sparrow. But I'm afraid when he's in the park, he leaves the straight and narrow. I raised this bird in a manner so strict, now I feel certain I'm being tricked. My canary heart circles on his eyes. Everybody whistle along. Refugee situation has just re-emerged again. It has never gone away, of course, up near Broome. And this is a song I wrote when that old man called John Howard was in power. Who remembers him? Ruined Australia, just about. And I think Ms. Scott Morrison was his minister. Scott Morrison's divorcing his wife because she had an affair with five of his ministers. it's a terrible. Unfortunately, it's a bit of a problem because replacing Scott Morrison with Peter Dutton is like shitting your pants and then changing your shirt. This is a song I wrote around those days. Beautiful days they were. Johnny Morrow, Johnny Howard, what a guy. And this is a song about refugees called, it's about the Wizard of Oz. And if Australia, you don't want the refugees to come to Australia, they'll have a bad time. Anyway, it's called The Land of Oz. Dorothy don't go to the Land of Oz. Dorothy don't go to Oz because the Tin Man hasn't got a heart, Scarecrow's brains are strong, the Lion has no courage, and the Wizard is a fraud. On chemicals that spew, the koalas dropped off from the twig as the highway rounds a bend. There's still a call in progress as we progress to the end. And in the wing they'll be all extinct, there'll be nothing left to do. In the Land of Oz with only memories of kangaroo and didgeridoo. To the Land of Oz. Dorothy, don't go to Oz because the Tin Man hasn't got a heart, Scarecrow's brains are strong, Lion has no courage, and Wizard is a fraud. Tin Man hasn't got a heart, he's too busy making money. It's a busy, busy business in the Land of Milk and Honey. Scarecrow hasn't got a brain, stuffing up his head. The Lion has no courage, he won't stand up for what's right. He looks for the easy exit, just in case there is a light. The Wizard's just a scared old man, an empty politician, full of lots of huff and puff, making paranoid decisions. The Tin Man, Scarecrow, Lion, and Wizard are the fiction, are they true? Or are they just a bit like maybe me or maybe you? Dorothy, don't go into the Land of Oz. Dorothy, don't go to Oz because the Tin Man hasn't got a heart, the Scarecrow's brains are strong, the Lion has no courage, and the Wizard is a fraud.
Oh,
Dieter Rader on the Glockenspiel, direct from Berlin. Thank you, Jefferson. I'll pay you later for that. Thanks. No, I've got a drink here, otherwise it'll spill everywhere. I've made a mess already. Here's another song about reality and illusion, this time about love. A song that you might know. If you do, sing along. It's called... What is it called? It's called...
Paper Moon now.
Paper Moon, that's it. Okay.
Paper Moon. Surely.
Okay.
Or as the Germans would say, Paper Moon.
That's not right, Rob. You would say Papiermond.
Oh, Papiermond. Was ist das denn?
A paper moon.
Ah, right. You Germans have got a word for everything, haven't you?
Lebensphilosophie.
Geschlechtsverkehr.
I toured these with the wonderful bees out in Germany a couple of times, and they're wonderful people. Let's give them a big round of applause. Anyway, there's a tune made famous by the famous ukulele arc and many others. I never feel nothing is real when I'm away from you, out of your embrace. This world's a temporary parking place. Beep, beep, taxi. A bubble from a new smile. The bubble has a rainbow in it. See, it's only a paper moon over a cardboard sea.
Believed in me. places, worn out places, worn out faces. Riding early for the daily races, going nowhere, and the tears are filling up the glasses. No expression, out my head I wanna drown my sorrow. No tomorrow, no tomorrow. And I find it kind of funny, I find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I ever had. I find it hard to tell you, cause I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very bad world.
The Australian, one thing about it is that during the COVID epidemic, a lot of people used newspapers as toilet paper. But you shouldn't use The Australian because it's only soft on right-wing assholes.
Mad world.
waiting now at the beginning of the world for the next event on the card, which is Darwin's evolutionary endurance steeplechase to be run over 200 million years. Now it's a hot, sticky day here at the beginning of the world. The track is heavy as it's been raining for 50,000 years, and there's large oceans and boiling mud pools all over the place. Now the early runners are emerging from the swamps and slime and taking up the position at the barrier. The big brontosaurus moved in first, followed in by pterodactyl. Triceratops is moving in. Stegosaurus is in. Also tomatosaurus. A few more dinosaurs. Dinoross. And finally the big Tyrannosaurus Rex. All in now, awaiting starter's orders in Darwin's evolutionary stakes. Lights are flashing. Racing! And the big brontosaurus jumped out well just as the close loop backfield of dinosaurs around the first turn, leaving the 120 million year mark. And there it is, the dolphins and the early primates have been happening from the enemy competition. But the dolphins, wait, there's been an incident. The dolphins have dived back in the water. From my position in the box, it's hard to say there's any interference, but the dolphins are definitely back in the water. So racing right away now, it's the early primates happening, number of species. Pterodactyls drop right back, triceratops is gone. On the outside now, it's Java Man from Peking Man. On the inside from Cro-Magnon Man and Neanderthal Man, but it's Homo sapiens by a low forehead and bushy eyebrow. Living the last prehistoric period of the last ice age, it's still Homo sapiens out in front, hampering the number of species. What a race, what a thriller, as they enter the Middle Ages, and a new challenge from the rats. The rats plaguing the Homo sapiens, giving a taste for own medicine. Homo sapiens don't like it, it's the rats, Homo sapiens, rats, Homo sapiens. Down the straight they go to the 20th century now. The Anson 6 moving up now, Anson 6, rats, Homo sapiens, Anson 6, and they go to the nuclear age in a big funny floppy. Cockroaches! The cockroaches fly down the street now. Cockroaches, Homo sapiens, cockroaches. And they pass the post, they can never forget it. I couldn't pick it. The judges have either called for a photo finish or an oil painting. Waiting for the judge's decision, and it's mankind by a short head and half a brain. Correct weight and the time, 2024 AD. Thank you. Back to the studio. Okay, here's a song I wrote about climate change. About 30 years ago, nobody was listening, but they still, some people I know at least. Oh, I guess those are the good old days. It's not, there's no climate change, it's just there, it's there now.
Oh, there it is, okay. Sorry about this.
I'm an old man, I can get lost. Okay, this is, Just to want to say though, it is about Armageddon, but just because I can't spell Armageddon, it's not the end of the world. Okay. This is about, like I use Wizard of Oz for a metaphor for the roof refugees, this is using Wizard of Oz. You'd be using the Titanic. Sorry, what am I saying? The Titanic for another metaphor. Okay, this is called Deck Chairs on the Titanic. There is a documentary that's been made about my brother and I, coming out sometime this year. Probably won't get anywhere, but anyway, you never know. And they've used this song quite a lot. So I've only seen a rough cut of the first half, but anyway, this song gets a mention. Cool deck chairs on the Titanic. Rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. Ship is sinking, but please don't panic. Sailing in that cold blue sea, rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. Changing the weather, changing the scene, money to burn temporarily. The ice caps are melting, the ozone's thin. Put on your hat, your shades, let's begin. Rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. Ship is sinking, but please don't panic. Let's toast the future, take a sip. Follow the captain down with the ship.
class war. The rich get rich and the rest are poor. You can't stop progress and stay afloat. You can change the curve but don't rock the boat. Rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. The ship is sinking, but please don't panic. Rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. Where?
Do this one. It's Road to Nowhere, I think it's called. And, when I was living in the inner west, I seriously protested against the M4 and the tunnel up to the Blue Mountains. Now I'm living in the Blue Mountains, so I think it's marvellous. Please pop up a second.
Shanana's runner, we've got torches for 9 months. Go see Bello, it's over there. He came to see you tonight. And go see Bello is now in charge of television and radio in Timor-Leste, everybody.
Let's give Jose Bello a round of applause. Thank you. We're going to do three more songs. And then we'll get out of your way. There's nothing like a great song, and this next one is nothing like one. Just gotta get put the saw on. The musical saw. Premature emasculation. People ask me about the saw, that this is a saw in the key of C. It's a seesaw.
Give us time to
work it out.
We're on the road to nowhere. Come on inside. Taking that ride.
Get my sister up to sing on this next song. This is a song I wouldn't normally hope that I never sing this song again, but I'm going to hope I never sing it again. It's the first time I've ever played it, and it'll be the last time, hopefully, I've ever played it. It's a song about you know who. So we want you to join in the chorus.
Would you like some Ritalin, Mick?
Yes, I would.
I've got some left.
So, free him from prison. Free Assange.
Yeah. Let's see.
I'm going to get the audience to do it. I can't remember the first words of the chorus. Release. That's the word. I was trying to work. Release my brain.
Yes, that's the most merciful release. Okay. Like,
release him from prison. Free Assange. So we want you to shout, free Assange, sing it, free Assange, do anything. But free Assange is the chorus. And we'll see you at the other end and anything can happen. Okay. Freedom of speech for all. Talk about protection under the law, human rights and democracy. But let's talk about victims of hypocrisy. Here we go. Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
No one should die for telling the truth. UK, US, Australia too. Dirty secrets away from you. Julian Assange, WikiLeaks more. Expose the secrets of a dirty war. Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
No one should die for telling the truth. Well, they locked him up for far too long for exposing some ugly wrongs. Make the punishment fit the crime. He's more than paid, he's done his time. Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
Release him from prison.
Free Assange.
Release him from prison.
Free Assange. No one should die for telling the truth.
Ding dong. Still going to keep playing anyway. No, we're finishing up and hope you've enjoyed the show. And, thank you so much for coming along and supporting an overdue it's about time. We're going to go back to my old Captain Matchbox days with this song called Wangaratta Wahine. In a long drive, my mind was far away. The lady at the counter asked me, "What do you want, love?" But as I looked towards the plastic palm trees, is all I could say. Wahine and Wangaratta.
This is not goodbye. We will love again. Wahine in Hawaii. It doesn't matter that we're apart. I still love you. Although I must go far down the road, the human way. Trucks will pass, gumblies fall. I'll return someday. She looked at me and said, "You're a great goon." Called her husband in. "Come here, Craig, we've got a live one here." He showed me in the door. "It is sunny, get out." And I departed with a heavy boot. But as I flew out, the summer breeze seemed to whisper to me, "Psst, psst, 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 Mawahine in Hawaii. Why, Goethe, this is not goodbye. We will look alone again." Could I forget the potted palm trees? The waves in her hair, swish, splash, swish, splash. I remember the little one. The sink while the water falls, shh. But most of all, I remember her husband, Craig, about 6'6", broad shoulders. What a whacker! Mawahine in Hawaii. Why, Goethe, this is not goodbye. We will do it again. Mawahine in Hawaii. It doesn't matter. No, 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 that we're fine. I still love you.
Thanks for listening to us. Thanks for having us. And thanks to Diane and everyone who organized this. Thank you.
The day will come when they're dragging Julian off in chains with a fucking hood over his head, where you will suddenly be outraged, right? It's been so obvious where this is going. And here we are. Their outrage will come, but please remember their timidity every day before that outrage that will happen. It will happen, and it might be very, very soon. I've got no words left, and I'm sure everyone here, all committed people, you don't need to hear any more speeches about how bad it is what's happened to Julian. Perhaps a little bright note. I'm here with Jose Bello, Tim Rees. Guerrilla leader, really, sitting on the wall over there. Jose lived through the toughest years in East Timor, moving between the students in Dili and the guerrillas in the mountains. And he became, undoubtedly, East Timor's most famous guerrilla journalist. All of the big leaks that came out of East Timor essentially, I mean, I'm not exaggerating, came through Julian, through Jose. But he told me, he was just staying with me, and he said, "Let's go down and we'll go to that event." And he just told me, I've known him for 20 years, he's never said it. He says, "Well, I think Julian was the guy that gave us our encrypted communications in the 90s. He was in Melbourne. I've just checked with someone, a friend of Julian's, and she said yes. From about 95 to about 99, Julian was doing work that was being felt in the mountains of East Timor. So there's a voice in Timor that's grateful. And as for perhaps a very blunt political message, if it happens, at the moment we've all been dreading, I can see no other political strategy than to bluntly and directly threaten the American alliance if they take Julian. It is the only card we have to play, and it's a bloody good card, right? It is a monster card, and it's going to take a political will amongst all of us to make that an issue. So stand by, stand by. Thank you.
Thanks, Mark. It's great to hear how great Australians. We've got great Australian artists, musicians. All we need is a couple of good politicians. So if anyone out there knows any, can you just give us their number and we'll try and get them on board. But no, the Parliament this week got behind the people who were behind Assange 10 years ago. It takes usually 10 years for a politician to catch up with the people. So hopefully we can get something. We've got John Shipton, Julian's father, coming up next to give us an idea of, and hopefully, I spoke to him last night and he left me in tears. Hopefully he won't leave you in tears and give us some hope. John, can you come and give us some hope, please? Give me some hope.
It's a bit like a family reunion, all these familiar faces from 14 years on the trail of a bit of justice for a great son of our soil, Julian Assange. I'll start with a couple of things. One is the gathered spirits of the 12,666 children that have died in Gaza, the 7,223 mothers that have died in Gaza. I ask for your forgiveness that my words were not compelling enough, my arm not strong enough. I ask for your forgiveness. For as men, we have one principal duty which falls upon our shoulders from the realization of manhood until the grave. We are called upon to look after the children, to defend the children and their mothers. So I ask, on behalf of all men, for the forgiveness that we weren't compelling, my words weren't compelling enough to save their sweet lives. Next. The most amazing thing has happened. It's a global problem. The repression of publication that is exemplified in Julian Assange. The collapse of free speech. A global problem throughout the West. Telephones as well. A global problem throughout the West. Next. The extraterritorial application of the United States laws universally to anywhere they so desire. A case is Julian Assange. Next. The courage to compel our governments to understand as James mentioned, that we've been on the trail for 10 years and they're just catching up. The motion that the Parliament carried, 84, 12 abstentions, rests on our shoulders. That is, that the Australian public and their Parliament are foremost in the world in resisting the application of United States laws to anybody that they so desire, extraterritorial, that they hate and want to destroy. We are there, our Parliament, resting on our people. That is us, you see, manifested. We're first in the world. Also first in the world in the defence of publication, publishers, journalists, and those journalists put upon by these great powers. We're there. The defence of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, the Australian Herbert Vere Evatt proposed this in 1948 in the United Nations, an Australian. He was third president of the United Nations. We're there for that. Next. Pretty impressive so far, but there's more. Our Parliament sent a delegation to Washington. A broad spectrum, you might call it, delegation in defence of Julian Assange. But essentially, what the Parliament did and what we have caused the Parliament to do is to re-establish Australian sovereignty. We make our own decisions. If a citizen is brutally, with malice, put upon by the great power of the United States, we have caused our government, our Parliament rather, to say no to that. You can't imagine how vital that is after the last 21 years of our involvement in Syria, our involvement in Iraq, our involvement in Afghanistan. And while we're there, we can laud and hold with reverence David McBride. There's only one way forward for us, and that is to hold too close to our hearts and reverence those who fight for us. That establishes a backbone, an understanding that those who have gone before us have done their best to establish the sovereignty of Australia. It comes to mind a dear, dear friend died last month, John Pilger. Reverence him. Gough Whitlam, an Australian who embraced as best he could the understanding that we have something to build here. We have a nation to build. We are not there. It's always just a little bit in front of us. There's lots to do. Last point I'll make is when you think of Australia, think of this. From the Torres Strait to Antarctica, we extend. From the other direction, from Norfolk Island to Christmas Island, we extend. That is us, a continent of unbounded wealth. We embrace Torres Strait. We embrace the Indian Ocean. We embrace the Southern Ocean, the Tasman Sea, the Pacific Ocean, all of the great oceans that constitute our planet, except for the Atlantic, are on our doorstep. We embrace them, they're a part of us. Australia is probably, along with South America, probably, aside from the world island, of course, Africa and the great continent. Because of its embrace of those islands and because of those oceans and because of its extraordinary wealth and because of the intelligence and desire of the people to be firm about the display of justice, we have a foundation upon which to carry us forward. But essential in that is to reverence those who work for us. Thank you, everybody. Oh, one more thing. There's a book doing the rounds with Michelle to get everybody to sign it. And at the end of the evening, I prevail upon James McGlone to auction it off. And thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much, John. That was wonderful.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks, John. We're going to have a short break now where we can all get to know each other and, just like in church, turn to the person you know least and say hello. Find out where they've been and where they're going and what we can do together to make a better world. Okay, and next we're going to have the band Sonido, but see us all soon. Well, listen, we've got this beautiful band called Sonido. They're Latin American based. They've got experience of 40 years and from very distinct artists. They've learned their art. Their music ranges from Andean playlists, Iyapu, and Irikeri. I probably didn't pronounce that properly. That's probably the Guinness talking rather than the Spanish. Yeah. But so they're going to give us a wonderful, wonderful rendition of all the beautiful sounds of the Andes and Chile and all those other beautiful South American countries. America are devastated.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a real honour to be here today, to be part of this event. Thank you for the organisers for the invitation. For us, we're all either born in Chile or born to Chilean parents. Sorry, I was about to say that in Spanish. Most of us were, I guess, forced to come to Australia. In my case, literally being born in a military dictatorship opened my world quite early to the reality of the injustices of what's going on in our planet. To get to this amazing paradise we call Australia, which really it is, to grow up in Western Sydney, surrounded by people that shared this immigrant experience, people from all around the world telling their stories and sharing the stories. It's amazing that what's happened to Julian can actually still happen in this day and age. It's not because we don't know. It's for those that choose to not see it. And so for us to be part of this is just amazing. This band was started in 1977, fortunately by my father and other musicians in Sydney that took on the mantle of maintaining our culture in a land far away when there was no YouTube or Spotify to keep in touch. And we've fortunately been able to carry these traditions on and these beautiful instruments. That was an original composition, that first piece dedicated to the kena that Marco was playing, which are these kind of bamboo flutes that you can see, the Andean flutes. We're going to continue with an original song that was only recently released on an album we put out called Waino del Wainot. Now the Waino for us is a very traditional, one of the most traditional rhythms from the Andean region, which includes Bolivia, Peru, Chile, many countries. Waino in Spanish, I guess, sounds like the word why not. So we married those two words together and wrote a song about basically saying why not, why, how can we not change the injustices of the world once we know that they exist. And this, we'd love to dedicate this song to everyone, to Julian, to everyone, his family, everyone here today, and this cause. This is Waino del Wainot. Other wind instruments you can see, there's some ponyas or the pan pipes known around the world. And Marco has the habit of blowing a lot in this heat, and this is called Arenales. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. We're going to do a piece that some of you may have heard before. I guess it goes without saying that we're singing mostly in Spanish, so we're going to try and stick to instrumentals so that we're not guessing what we're saying. This is a piece that was, I guess, controversially used by Simon and Garfunkel. They did a version of an instrumental piece that was written in Peru. Unfortunately for Simon and Garfunkel, they didn't ask for permission and they just grabbed this recording and put some words on top, made it a worldwide hit. And fortunately for a band called Los Incas, they got heaps of royalties and they're still earning those royalties today. So, so that was a victory for, in one way. We're going to play this piece, which is iconic. It's known all around the world as El Cóndor Pasa and features all of the traditional instruments. You can see this little guy called charango, which is like a 10-stringed kind of mandolin-sounding high-pitched guitar made after the Spanish arrived by the Incas at the time, copying the Spanish guitar. The guitar, which is, I guess, influences directly from Spain. The zampoñas and the quenas, and the bombo, which is the cowhide drum that you can see over here. This is El Cóndor Pasa. Oh, we will not say no to some water. Yes, would you like some water? That's great, thank you.
Water feels good sometimes.
Sometimes. All right.
Thank you. Thank you. As I mentioned earlier, this band started in 1977. You probably guess not. Some of these guys probably weren't born in 1977. Otherwise, we look fantastic. So we'd like to invite one of the original members or earlier members of the group, who's fortunately also my dad. So give it up for Oscar Marin. Thank you. We're going to do two songs to finish off, which he's fortunately joined us to sing. We're usually an eight-piece band with drums and pianos and all sorts of crazy things. We kind of shrunk a little bit for today so that we could make this okay for everyone. And I'll leave the last word to the boss.
Oh yeah, and when someone is missing, they call me. And look, I see that earlier, when you're forced to leave your country, no matter where you end up, you miss your culture, you miss your neighborhood, you miss your streets, you miss everything until you get used to it. A Uruguayan singer-songwriter wrote this, the next song where he says that he explains and he tells of all the things that he missed from his, as he called it, his little country. This is back in Uruguay. The song is called Está Llorando, which means it's crying.
Cuando en tierras extrañas miro triste la lejanía azul del horizonte, siento clarito el olivar que pasa y la brisa que trae olor a monte. Siento clarito el olivar que pasa y la brisa que trae olor a monte. Este cielo no es el cielo de mi tierra, y esta luna no brilla como aquella que alumbró mis sueños santos, más santos que el temblor de las estrellas, como aquella que alumbró mis sueños santos, más santos que el temblor de las estrellas. Las voces y miradas tan queridas ya no están en el boliche ni en los asados. Otros vagan sin consuelo por el mundo. Ay, paisito, mi corazón está llorando. Otros vagan sin consuelo por el mundo. Ay, paisito, mi corazón está llorando. Sierras, montes, ríos y llanuras. Adiós, viejo pelao, rubio y serrano. Chao, Bilbao, mano de la onda, conmigo. Ay, paisito, de corazón está llorando. Chao, Bilbao, mano de la onda, conmigo. Ay, paisito, mi corazón
Thank you very much. Thank you. Our next and final song is Victor Jara. Victor Jara was a Chilean singer, songwriter, actor, theater director, poet, and he was a voice. He was a voice of poor people. He was a voice of the workers, and because of that, because he accused the abuses that used to happen in Chile, because of that, he was killed only hours after the Pinochet military dictatorship took power. In the 60s and 70s, he wrote a song about the war in Vietnam, about the abuses, about the genocide by the US government in those days. And he called this song El Derecho de Vivir en Paz, which means the right to live in peace.
CIA
sabotage
to his helicopter in Patagonia.
Uh-huh. He knows something. Yeah. Oh. Looks like. Yeah. Okay.
It's cutting
from out. Victor Jara, El Derecho de Vivir en Paz.
El derecho de vivir, poeta Ho Chi Minh, que golpea de Vietnam a toda la humanidad, ningún cañón borrará el surco de tu arrozal. Thank you.
thank you very much.
Thank you.
Big hand for Sunita, that was beautiful, wasn't it? Born and bred in Australia, with her hearts in South America and the Andes. Our babies. All the way home. All the way home. God, we breed some beautiful things over here, don't we? Talking about beautiful things, we've got another beautiful man here, David McBride. And as you know, he's up for sentencing soon, and God forbid they're going to pollute our prison population with more intellect than they deserve. So let's have David McBride up here, and hopefully he can give us some good news.
Thank you so much. And the good news is coming from you people. It makes me so happy to see this crowd here tonight. Sold out. In fact, one of my friends has got their nose out of joint because they couldn't get in. So it's this is the most exclusive town party in town tonight. Who would have thought? Everybody wants to be a Sarn supporter now. And how good was that that band we just heard? Anyway, I've only got they were pretty good. And I 3 weeks before sentence, everybody here knows me very well. You're all like family, and I don't think I've ever been so charged walking into a room in, you know, well, maybe in my whole life actually. That, you know, to be in this crowd, just feel the energy and the goodwill. And as I've said before, while it's darkest before the dawn, we will win this. We will absolutely win this. I know it's a bit of a mystery, but I will win the appeal against the judge's bizarre decision, a bit like in Julian's case, to say there are no exceptions to handing over classified information under the Holocaust or, you know, selling secrets to the enemy. You know, it just cannot stand. And that's, we've played the government into a corner where they have pushed that, and the same as they will try to do with Julian, to say they cannot have somebody discussing the evil which is in the documents as opposed to whatever possible damage might have been caused by their releasing. Because if you weigh those two things up, both Julian and I are clearly in the right. There's no doubt about it. The government can't make laws to say it's illegal to expose government crime. I mean, it's laughable. It's laughable. And that is such a strong truth. We will have to win. We might not win this year. We might not win next year, but we will win. And God, it will be so sweet. It will be so, so sweet. You look back on the things from the 1960s, 70s, and no one, you know, the trial of the Chicago 7 and things like that, it's not the government that the heroes. You people will be the heroes in the movies they make about this in 20 years' time. And you will do more than star in movies. You know, I really believe that this is the fight that will save the world from a dystopian future. And anyway, I just want to thank you all so much. I may be imprisoned, but we have won the public fight, as Julian has, and now a very small but important thing happened last week where all the government people are actually saying, yeah, well, he's not such a bad guy after all. Go figure. And then how can they keep me in jail if he's a bad guy? Certainly not a bad guy. Anyway, you are all heroes to me. You are all family to me. And I just want to thank you. And I can, while it's not clear to everybody, I can see it. I can feel it in my bones, in my Irish bones, that we will win this. So thank you so much.
Winston here from Action for Assange in the States. Thank you so much for asking me to be a small part of your event tonight. I am genuinely honored that you would think to ask me. I have been a big fan of the work that you all have been doing over there for a very long time. What you've managed to accomplish is nothing short of incredible. And frankly, I don't think you get near enough credit. And I know that's not why you do it, but I just want you to know that I see you and I thank you. You have been in the trenches on what is, in my opinion, probably the single most important issue of our time. And the things you've been able to accomplish have been nothing short of incredible. So keep up that fight. Keep up the good work. I see you. I thank you. And let's go crush some bastards and free Assange, shall we? Thanks, guys.
Maybe that's all you need to know when it ultimately peeks through. You need to go it alone. Come on, it ain't that hard. Free Julian Assange, he's being held without charge. Free Julian Assange, mighty England, all on your own. There's a job to do. Be true to yourself. Stand up. Don't cloud deception with your rules. Come on. Come on. It ain't that hard.
It ain't that hard.
Free Julian Assange. He's being held without charge.
It ain't that hard.
Free Julian.
Hello from London, I'm Stella Assange. Julian Assange is my husband. Thank you so much for your staunch support and relentless activism for my husband, Julian Assange. Australia has been instrumental in keeping Julian's case at the forefront of public consciousness. It means so much that Julian's fellow countrymen are fighting for his freedom. People often ask what they need to do to help free my husband. There are two things that you can do right now as Australians. The first is to sign up to the Meet Your MP program. As of February 2023, when it was launched, there have been 59 meetings held with 50 MPs across all political parties in Australia. 1,600 Australians have signed up. We need more, so please, please sign up and join them. The second thing is of extreme urgency. In just a few days, on Tuesday and Wednesday, the 20th and the 21st of February, there will be a new public hearing at the Royal Courts of Justice here in London. we are streaming a 24-hour countdown on my YouTube channel, at Stella Assange, starting on the 19th of February at 8:30 a.m. London time. Please tune in for actions, resources, and information for this fight for Julian's freedom. Please check my website, stellaassange.com, which will have locations in Australia. If your location is not there, then please just start your own protest. We need as many protests on the day and as much awareness as possible.
There's a great man in this building now whose birthday is today, and he's been a big, big supporter of Julian Assange. He's been to many, many marches for Julian, as with many other causes. He's marched for freedom, he's marched for Palestine, he's marched... In fact, I'm surprised he can even walk, he's marched that far, you know? Can we have Dave up on stage to get your birthday cake and blow out these candles and give us a couple of words of wisdom, Dave, please.
God bless you, brother. What a privilege it is to be here amongst friends tonight. Looking out at this gathering, it just reminds me of a group of old soldiers. We've been fighting these battles for so many years now. We're veterans of many conflicts, and we've taken many injuries, and some of us are still under fire. It's the reality of being in the front line. We get shot at, we get injured, and we get up again, and we keep going. You know, sometimes I'm tempted to think, oh no, God's in his heavens, all's right with the world, but no. Then I think of Julian as my touchstone. While Julian continues to be crucified, all is not right with the world. Julian is the touchstone, is the emblem of everything that is wrong. The persecution of people who speak the truth. And yet, we think of all the suffering he's gone through, the suffering so many of us have gone through. And yet, as the gospel writer says, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness is never going to put it out. That, for me, is the gospel of hope. The light shines in the darkness, and Julian's light continues to shine in the darkness, and that darkness is never going to put it out. Thanks be to God, and thank you all. Thank you. God bless you all.
Thank you, Dave. Before you go, we all know what his wish is going to be, but he can't tell us, okay? And if it's for the lotto, we can kick in the death in the hallway out there. But you can just give us a quick blow there, you know, in a friendly way. And then you make this beautiful wish that's going to make it all come true and all our dreams. Please, Father Dave, not the lottery. He's left one alive. Oh, he's got it. He got it. Okay. Now next we're going to have a beautiful... Okay. Yeah, we're going to say... Do I have to sing happy birthday to him? Jesus, I don't even know the words. It's one of the worst songs I've ever heard. Can anyone get up here and do happy birthday with gusto? Come on, hands up. Come on.
Who's... Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Dave. Happy birthday.
So next we're going to have this wonderful Australian artist, Boadicea McGlone, who looked after Julian's children before they were announced as being alive and on the planet. She looked after them while the court cases were going on, and her mother was deep in legal, entrenched in legal battles, and her father was locked up, as he still is. And Bodie went over there with John, and she looked after the children. And she's here tonight.
When are we going to free Julian Assange, guys? We're Australian, and he's not home yet, and I feel kind of embarrassed being Australian when I'm overseas, because I'm like, you know, I don't feel like we're bringing him back. We've got to be stronger as a country. We've got to bring him back. You know, you go over to America and they're so patriotic, they're like, yeah, we're American. But look, no, we're Australian, and I think we should bring Julian Assange home because he's one of us and he deserves to be at home with his family. I know his family quite well, and I had the, you know, pleasure of hanging out with these little kids when I was over in the UK, and they're so sweet, and they deserve to be home with their dad. And the assholes that committed the crimes get to go home to their family. How is that fair? You know, it's not fair, but you know, I feel like we're doing a good job. We're going to get him back. He's going to be here soon, and everyone else that speaks the truth out there. I'm going to sing a few original songs. This was one of the songs I wrote a while ago, so I felt like, start from the beginning. Blue shoes, flowers, guns, why don't you look in your eyes, deep surprise, surrender, speak. Silent whispers, long lost sisters to the weak. Blue shoes, flowers, guns, why don't you love me? You had a fight, you loved the right, you went to bed, you woke up red. Noodles or rice, don't say it twice. Don't you need me? Please don't leave me. Blue shoes, flowers, guns, why don't you love me? Why don't you? A star, but nobody wants to try, and everyone wants to be in heaven, but nobody wants to die. So unwrap me, I dare you. Cause I wanna see what's inside. I wanna feel you inside. Cause everyone wants to be a star, but nobody wants to try, and everyone wants to be
that's love for the loves that could have been. Let's see for the beauty in the unseen. Let's forget those unborn memories, 'cause everyone wants to be a star, but nobody wants to try, and everyone wants to be in heaven, but nobody wants to die. So kill me now, 'cause I wanna live forever. Kill me now, 'cause I wanna live. Should've loved me yesterday, could've loved me yesterday. Should've loved me yesterday. Should have loved me yesterday. Could have loved me yesterday. 'Cause everyone wants to be a star, but nobody wants to try, and everyone wants to be in heaven, but nobody wants to die. So love me
friend, as I may you.
change the rain to you the sun. Next song I'm gonna sing, I feel like sadly a lot of people can relate to it, but it's not sad. It's about being strong and charging on and know that you've got your own back. I think it's the most important thing. So you finally leave me. Now I know you'll need me. I'll be there to wipe the tear from your eyes. And so you finally gone. Sit and sing your hear its song. I know that someone's loving you tonight. Someone else is holding you, but that's alright. 'Cause I don't need your love. Lucky to be named after the woman Boadicea Boudica. So, I've actually heard reincarnate. I haven't worked out. People say, you know, you've got a lot to live up to with your name, and I think just haven't worked out who I'm going to kill a lot of people yet. I'm trying to work it out. You know, she just went the Romans, but she was looking after her family and standing up for herself. So she's like. She's my hero, so rigorous. What was that? Oh, I'll take that as a compliment. Just need a bit of a chariot. I'm working on it. So this is called Boudica. I'm Boudica. Killed 60,000 Romans in one day, but I would love half if they could see my way. Shorts of gold, story untold, conquering bastards unfold. Men in deathly grey, beautiful colours decay. For Boudica, Boudica,
So why don't you call my name? Sing it loud, I will be the boy. Why don't you call for me? Paintings being packed away. Corona got its way. Toilet paper is running away. Is running away. Only one day they'll pray. One day you'll pray for booty cat. Booty cat. So why don't you call my name? Sing it loud, I will be the boy. Why don't you call for me? Sing my name, I will be the girl. Why do you treat me like you do? 2,000 years inside this suit.
I'm going to sing one more song, and this song was, it's called Sophie Scholes, and it's after another powerful woman, someone who I look up to a lot. So for those who don't know who Sophie Scholes was, she, she went against the Nazis, and her and her brother end up getting the guillotine for hanging up posters pretty much. So she was 21, and the last day, you guys hearing that? Like, yes. Ooh, is it like a weird effect? But it was my mind. Sometimes I think I'm hearing things. Well, not all the time. Don't call the ambulance on me. We all hear things, but oh, there it is. It's gone. It's not just humming. In your brain. But yeah, just before she died, she said, and this song's for her. She said, just before her and her brother got the guillotine, she was 21, he was a couple years older. She said, how can we expect righteousness to prevail when there is hardly anyone willing to give himself up individually to a righteous cause? Such a fine sunny day and I have to go. But what does my death matter if through us thousands of people are awakened and stirred to action? Sophie Scholl. This song's for her and for her brother and for everyone else that loses their lives for speaking the truth. Thank you.
Sophie's gold. You gave it all and they took your life. Only 21, your life had just begun. You were fighting for us all. So tell me the truth. Tell me the truth. I am not accountable, but I'm accountable for you. That you need a whisper and no longer need it. Tense in a row, waking to that morning snow when you fight. Smoky clouds, men dressed in bubble wrap with cotton bow ties, wondering why. I'm wondering why the birds fly. Sophie's gold, you gave it all and they took your life. Only 21, your life had just begun. You were fighting for us all.
Thank you everyone for coming and supporting Julian. Now we've already had this song tonight, but I got a call from Bob Dylan this morning and he said, I've written a new verse for this old song and I'd like you to sing it tonight. I said, all right, Bob, for you, anything, you know. And it went like this. I saw Albanese on the TV. He said it's time to set Julian free. He's been in jail for so long. Long for me. I see my light come shine. That's the way you say it, beautiful. Sing this one, write it for us, you know. Let's sing it one more time. I see my light come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, Julian shall be released. Thank you very much. So basically, one of the reasons I've been invited to come tonight is because, back in the noughties, I think it was, what day? It must have been about 2012 or something like that, I don't know, years ago. I was asked to sing a song at an Assange rally, and I had this song I was going to sing about drone warfare. And I sat down at my little computer and I was going to print up a lyric sheet of it because I was still learning it. And suddenly this inspiration came to me, and I was thinking about Julian, and I thought, your dirty little secret ain't a secret anymore. You know? So, the song just came out of the heavens and landed in my lap. And afterwards, I realized that it was Woody Guthrie's 100th birthday in 2012. It was in July. And this is the chorus I got. It goes, your dirty little secret ain't a secret anymore. We know what you're doing in your dirty little war. It's the same thing you've been doing time and time and time before. Your dirty little secret ain't a secret anymore. So this song was basically inspired by that video of Collateral Murder, you know, the one where the helicopter gunship crew, they see these people walking around, like, hey, look, there's some people, let's kill them, you know. It's like they're playing a computer game or something, you know. They don't know the difference. A lot of the people in the American Army, they recruit them according to how well they can play these computer games, and they treat the whole business of war as if it was just, they're not real people, and they're fucking killing people, you know. The helicopter gunship crew thought they were all just actors. There's video of men and children used for target practice. WikiLeaks released it. It's not rumor now, it's fact, it's evidence of cowboys shooting up the town. And your dirty little secret ain't a secret anymore. We know what you're doing in your dirty little war. It's the same thing you've been doing time and time and time before. Your dirty little secret ain't a secret anymore. Well, it's hard to keep a secret in the age of information. You push one little button and it's on every TV station. And anyone who isn't blind can see the situation now, 'cause Julian Assange was around. And your you're doing in your dirty little war. It's the same thing you've been doing time and time and time before.
Your dirty little secret is a secret anymore.
I can hear everyone over here singing. I can't hear you guys. I can't hear you. Back once upon a time, back when I was in my youth, the US Army war machine would cover up the truth. But they can't do that anymore, because now we've got the proof of the way they like to show, throw their weight around. Your dirty little secret
ain't a secret anymore.
We know what you're doing in your dirty little war. The same thing you've been doing. Expression, don't kill the messenger. Well, Julian Assange is a messenger. He's not a traitor. He held up a mirror to the people of the USA to show them what is really going down. And your dirty little secret. That's it. We know what you're doing in your dirty little war. It's the same thing you've been doing time and time and time before. Your dirty little secret ain't a secret. Your dirty little secret ain't a secret.
secret anymore. Now, when I was talking to Bob Dylan on the phone this morning, he said, I tell you what, it's a good song to be singing at a rally in favour, you know, like the whole, like I wore my John Lennon shirt just to be in the right vibe, you know. But this is a song that Bob wrote when he was about 21 or something, you know. So we have rallies every Friday afternoon at Sydney Town Hall. And this, one of the regulars of the Assange rallies said, can you play Masters of War? I said, for you, Eddie. Call me Masters of War. You that build the big guns. You that build the death planes. You that build all the bombs. You that hide behind walls. You that hide behind desks. I just want you to know I can see through your mask. Never done nothing but build to destroy. You play with my world like it's your little toy. You put a gun in my hand and you hide from my eyes. Then you turn and run faster when the fast bullets fly. Like Judas of old, you lie and deceive. That World War can be won, you won't need to believe. For threatening my baby, unborn and unnamed, you ain't worth the blood that runs in your veins. I'll follow your casket on a pale afternoon. I'll watch while you're lured into your deathbed. And I'll stand over your grave till I'm sure that you're dead. Come, you masters of war. You that build the big guns. You that build the death planes. You that build all the bombs. You that hide behind walls. You that hide behind desks. I just want you to know I can see through your mask. So that was, Bob wrote that about 60 years ago, and this song was about 10 years after that. This is Uncle Sam's modus operandi, his agenda, okay? It's called Political Science. You know this song? It goes like this. No one likes us, I don't know why. We may not be perfect, but heaven knows we try. All around, even our old friends put us down. Let's drop the big one and see what happens. We give them money, are they grateful? No, they're spiteful and they're hateful. They don't respect us. Let's surprise them. We'll drop the big one and pulverize them. Asia's crowded, Europe's too old, Africa's too hot, and Canada's too cold. South America stole our name. Let's drop the big one There'll be no one left to blame. We'll save Australia. Don't want to hurt no kangaroos. We'll build an all-American amusement park there. They got surfing too. Boom goes London, boom Paris. More room for you, more room for me. Every city, the whole world round, will just be another American town. How peaceful it'll be, we'll set everybody free. You'll be wearing a Japanese kimono, baby, it'll be Italian shoes for me. They all hate us anyhow, so let's drop the big one now. Let's drop the big one now. Now, does everyone know who wrote that song? Randy Newman. One of my great favourite songwriters. Now, I told you before, I had this song about drone warfare, right? Now, I wrote it about, I don't know, 15 years ago or something, and I never got around to performing it very much. So I thought, well, I better sing it here tonight. But I've been trying to remember it, and it's bloody difficult. But anyway, let's hope I don't mess it up, okay? Now, this is about, I was inspired by a TV show where it was a courtroom drama, and there was this soldier who was being court-martialed, and this solicitor, this lawyer, was defending the soldier. And it turned out the soldier's defense was, well, I just did what they told me to do. And he was being charged with a war crime. Anyway, what I didn't realize until it got into the drama of it all, he wasn't even there in Afghanistan. He was back in America fighting with a drone on a computer back in the USA. I thought, wait a second, that's not what happens, is it? Apparently that's how it works. So I've got this song, it's called Captain Walker. Goes, Captain Walker went to war this morning. At 10 a.m. an Afghan village burned. 47 children, 23 adult civilians were sent to meet their maker, we have learned. Captain Walker took time out for coffee, as usual, at about 11 a.m. Tonight, as always, he'll be with his family. He's never even seen Afghanistan. He's making war in comfort and safety, from the base back home in the good old USA. Every night he says a prayer of thanks to the Christian deity. Praise the Lord for technology. No, sir, this ain't no science fiction. This is reality today. People, soldiers what? Soldiers in America can wipe out people anywhere. The drones will come and get us all one day. Captain Walker always follows orders. Captain Walker does what he is told. When they tell him, kill that heathen terrorist, even if she's only 3 years old. No, sorry, this ain't no science fiction. This is reality today. Soldiers in America can take out people anywhere. The drones will come and get us all one day. Soldiers in America can take out anyone, anywhere. The drones will come and get us all one day. The drones will come and get us all one day. So, you know, like in World War One, they killed all the soldiers. Now they don't. They keep them much more tidy. They don't kill the soldiers anymore. They just kill the people. Anyway. Marianne, what would you like to hear? A Sydney song. All right, well, how about, now here's a song about when I was a young street singer in the 70s. I would have been, like, I'm 71 now, I would have been 21, 22, 50 years ago. And there was an old girl who was homeless. She would have been in her 70s. And she was only, you know, about 5 foot tall, 5 foot round. She had a big smile, but she had no teeth. And she was homeless, but whenever she would see some sort of event like a cinema premiere or a Festival of Sydney event, or even just a young busker like me on Circular Quay, she would take that as an opportunity for her to live out her dream of being a ballerina. So she was a ballerina and I was the orchestra. And I got this song that went, dance, dance, Dorothy, dance. I've got a guitar. She hears an orchestra dance, dance, Dorothy. Dance and your spirit will be free. You want to try that again? Try it. Dance, dance, Dorothy, dance. I've got a guitar. She hears an orchestra dance, dance, Dorothy. Dance and your spirit will be free. Now Dorothy is a friend of mine, I see her all the time. She'll dance when I play on Circular Quay. She's got no money to put in my case, but the smile on her face will always make my day. Dorothy doesn't have any place to call home, so she treats Sydney as if it's her own. People scurry to the ferry all day in too much of a hurry to hear what I play. But Dorothy, with time to spare, dances around and calls for a chorus of the Bag Lady's Waltz. You got the chorus? Dance, dance, Dorothy, dance. I've got a guitar. She hears an orchestra dance, dance, Dorothy. Dance and your spirit will be free. Na, 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 na. Dorothy wears all her dresses at once. She rotates them all every couple of months. She would never say she is poor. The Salvation Army's always got more. And Dorothy doesn't have any place to call home. She treats Sydney as if it's her own. People scurry to the ferry all day in too much of a hurry to hear what I play. Dorothy, with time to spare, dances around and calls for another chorus of the Bag Lady's Waltz. You ready? Dance, dance, Dorothy, dance. I've got a guitar, but she hears an orchestra dance, dance, Dorothy, yeah, dance. Your spirit will dance, dance, Dorothy, dance. I've got a guitar. She is an orchestra dance, dance, Dorothy, yeah. Dance and your spirit will be free. Play a little tribute now. You see famous people, rock stars, movie stars, other, you know, politicians, whatever. every now and then, as we're getting older, we see, oh, there's somebody I used to know and they've just died, you know, and it's very sad. It's happening all the time. People are dying all the fucking time. But recently when Melanie died, I met her when she was here about 50 years ago, and she was the most gorgeous thing. And I never realised how much I loved her until I read that she just died, and I just had a flood of tears. Anyway, this one's for Melanie. This one's for Marianne's brother who passed the other day. You can dedicate to anyone of your nearest and dearest who you might have lost recently or at any stage, really. Don't forget to tell the people you love that you love them. Your family and your friends. Tell them when you think of them. You never know when you're never gonna see them again. We're not driving this bus, we're on. Yeah, we're just passengers. All we can do is get off at the stop. We can't control how heavy the traffic is, or if we get where we're going late or not. I wake up in the morning and I think about the life I live and the friends I got. Even in my time of fear and doubt, I wouldn't be anyone else for $1 million. You can fantasize about what you could be. A millionaire, a rock and roll star. Don't forget you could be a refugee. Thank your lucky stars for who you are. And don't forget to tell the people you love that you love them. They drive you mad sometimes, but they're your friends. Tell them when you think of them. You never know when you're never gonna see them again. You never know when you'll never see them again. Thank you. All right, I think Billy's ready to go. I'll do one more song. Pardon? The War Is Over song, yeah. Now, I'm not going to sing the Christmas song right now, but I'll sing it at Christmas time, I promise. This is a song that's... some people don't understand how this song works. They think it, just because it's really sad, that they've got to be very filled. It's actually supposed to be a joke, all right? So just relax. Just appreciate it in a sort of a Tom Waits kind of mode of humour, right? Very dark humour, but it's sort of a true story as well. Happened to a friend of mine, it goes like this. Wedding ring for sale. It's brand new. Still in the box that I bought it in. I'll sell it cheap to you. She left me standing at the altar. It's like this, oh, like that, okay? She left me standing at the altar. She couldn't say I do. She said, it's not your fault. She said, I just gotta go. I stood there like a fool in front of my friends. I said, sorry. She's not coming. Here's where the wedding ends. She said, thanks for everything. It was great sex. I read that out at the reception. She sent it in a text. Let's drink away sorrow. I'll get as drunk as I can get. I'm gonna feel the pain tomorrow. Tonight I'll drink to forget. Raise up your glass to pitiful me. If you want that wedding ring, you can have it for free. It was her idea. She said she wanted to get married. I said, sweetheart, if you want to get married, we'll do whatever you want to do. And then she left me standing at the altar. She couldn't say I do. She said, it's not your fault. She said, I just gotta go. Thank you. Now see, now she got it. Thank you very much. You know what, of all of the audiences I've ever played for, you are one of them. Thank you very much. Go, Julian. Let's try one more time. I see my light come shining from the west down to the east. Once more with feeling. Very much. You know, I love hanging out with the Assange support group because they're so real. You know, they're not full of themselves or, you know, they're just really supporting the cause. And look who we got, ladies and gentlemen. We've got Billy Field. Thank you very much. See you down Sydney Town Hall sometime, okay? Thank you very much, everyone.
This book by Professor Nils Melzer is the entirety of the persecution of Julian Assange. Nils Melzer's observation after his investigation as the rapporteur on torture said that we are witnessing before our eyes a slow motion murder. Everybody who is here tonight has signed this book, okay? There's three pages of signatures, four pages and a dedication. So it's going to be auction, so we can have a bid, please. Let's start at $50. Anybody want 50? There's 50 there. Anybody more than 50? Come on, Peter. 60, there's 60 over there. It's a very, very valuable book. Actually, it sells in the shop for $50 without the signatures of all the people at this event tonight. I even put my signature there. There you go. You can even, you know, look, if you get this book, you can take the short-term view or the long-term view. Hang on to it, it'll be worth a fortune. Or give it away for Christmas in the short-term view. Any more than 60? $70 over there, good-o. $100, my God, yeah. $100, that's caused the perspiration to break out. $100, good God. $110 over there. 110 going at 110. 120 up there, a lady. 130 with a credit card. We take credit cards. We take a few of them. Any more than 130? Can't see any. 140 over there, 140. Come on somebody, 150 will do. 150 there. Anybody greater than 150? Going once. 160 over there. There's a very wealthy woman up the back there. So one, what was it, 180, good God. 180 there. This book is going to be a valuable artifact. It'll be in the Mitchell Library, and your grandchildren will come along and point it out. Oh, 200. Your grandchildren will come along and point out that that book I donated to the Mitchell Library. It's got all the signatures of a very, very powerful and wonderful group of people. I can read some of them to you. Who's there? Like Mark Davis, the great solicitor, Rebecca McGlone, the beautiful redhead somewhere around here, Natasha. Natasha's a Russian. She's the only Russian in the building. Who else is here? Catherine Howard, Virginia Hatter, Reg Norberg, Jean Elliott, Dawn Fraser. That must be Dan Fraser, sorry. there's a lot of good people here. I should stop making silly jokes. So 200 we're at. 220. Final call on 220. Going once. Going... Billy's getting impatient. Stop upping the bidding.
Take your time. We need the money.
230 over there.
Oh, it's cost money. Please, chip in, folks.
250. Who's going to offer 250 and then we'll call it off? Okay, 250 going once. 260. 260 going once. I'm not accepting any more bids, that's it. I had enough. 260 going once, going twice, going three times. 260 over there for the young woman in black.
Privileged to be with really an enlightened audience. I think all of us realize that we all need liberty. And we all need human rights. And there's been some very, very brave and courageous people that have fought for them over the years. And that's the only reason we have any semblance of human rights. And Julian Assange will go down history as being one of the greatest people that fought the juggernaut, the murder machine, because that's what it is. It's a murder machine for private profit. And when people in the military stand up for treating human beings like human beings, as David McBride has, it's imperative we stand behind him all the way. More piano in the fallback, please. Test a little bit more vocal. You must have lunch real soon. Your luggage is checked through. We've got inflation, and I'll get right back to you. It's just a standard form. Tomorrow without fail. Pleased to meet you, thanks a lot. The check is in the mail. Maroon, maroon, maroon. Dear, the blizzard of my life. Maroon. marooned in the bliss of lies. You better watch your step when your old dog Shep won't even look you in the eyes. When you're blown at last, you double cross when you're marooned in the bliss of lies. Shrink or peel. Your secret's safe with me. This is a real good deal. Well, it's finger licking good. It's strictly by the book. What's fair is fair. I'll be right there. I am not a crook. Marooned in a blizzard of lies. Marooned in a blizzard of lies. To watch your step when your old dog Shep won't even look you in the eyes. Well, it looks like snow, but you never know when you're marooned in a blizzard of lies. We'll send someone right out. Now this won't hurt a bit. Animating now, the coat's a perfect fit. Well, it's strictly fresh today. It's service with a smile. I love you, darling, till I die. We'll keep your name on file. Marooned, the blizzard of lies. Marooned in the blizzard of lies. Walk on with hope in your heart. You're in for a big surprise when you're marooned. Marooned in a blizzard of lies. So you have to help me with this one.
Yeah. club, go out there to the gaming club, yeah. Watch out to make a duck, honey, I never could. Cause I've got more bad habits than you want. When I get to go, I just got to slow. I'm a slave to all. Cause I can't repress all my ways, help me now. Bad. Oh, I can't hear that. I said all my ways. Bad. One more, baby.
Thanks very much, that's very kind of you. Like, I wish, I'm sure you'll appreciate business has been bad the last few years because of COVID and everything like that. And I've had to club back on the expenses. Had to cut the expenses right down so I don't have the band. But it's your lucky night. It's your lucky night because I've got my 40-piece orchestra here in the iPad. This is a big investment. Big investment in my act. It cost me $120. And it's just so imperative we're all free to go where we want and to be what we want to be. Governments are there to facilitate our freedoms and our rights, not to tell us what to do. And we're gradually moving into this situation where we're all controlled. I'm going to do this song because to me it's emblematic of being free, getting up and just going away to wherever you like. So come fly with me. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Oh, if you can use some exotic use as a bar, far about me. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to the roof. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band and into his flute for you. Oh, come fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Yeah. Once I get you up there, where the air is all around fire, we'll just glide, we'll be starry eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so high that you might even hear. I will end you with cheer, cause we're together. Well, such a groovy day. Watch us say the words and we'll be the blues down to double bass. Well, it's perfect for a flying honeymoon. They all sing, come fly with me, once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. But you not even here. I will end your cheer, cause we'll forget. Well, wise, come on, mama, let's get away. You just say one word and we'll beat the birds up to Byron Bay. Why, it's perfect for a flying
honeymoon. And then all say, come fly with me. Let's fly, let's fly. Fly now, pack up, let's fly. Anyway, I'd like to, there's so many wonderful people here that have worked hard for years and years to try and bring it to the public's attention and to the government's attention. I don't think anyone's worked harder than John Shipton. Yeah, what a hero. So I'm going to sing my favorite song for John Shipton. It's called The More I See You. Sing a song for David, but it's for Julian too. because I think there's an old saying, the lowest point is the turn of the tide. Doesn't matter how low you get, when you get to the very bottom, that's the turn of the tide, and I hope that's the situation. So this is a song of hope, which was written by the wonderful George Harrison. And I absolutely love this song. It's called Blow Away. Dead time crack, sky to fall, rainbows appear, crash was bliss. Hard to remember, state I was in, instant amnesia, the end to the end. All I've got to do is to love you. All I've got to be is to remind me. All it's got to take is something.
Bye.
Here's one for you. Oh, you remember this one? Yeah. I'm just in your love, and everywhere I go, people on the board I'm playing. Pray for every dance, sending each romance. Oh, what a song. Wow. They sat on that. When the end comes, I know it's just a deal of life goes up without me. I'm just a deal of life. And everywhere I go, the people know the part I'm playing. Beg for every dance, sending each other. Oh, what they say. Just to dig it up, I've come up without me, because I ain't got nobody. Oh, there is a nobody. You can't find me, it's nobody. You can't find me. I'm so sad and lonely. With me, cause I'm not so bad. I said, sing it. Sweet love songs, up and off the top. Yeah, baby, that's it. And it works for me. Oh, zit a bitty bop, bitty bop, bitty bop. There's nobody cares for me. Nobody cares.
This is about the one that got away. You know that one that gets away. You know what Dorothy Parker said, don't you? Dorothy Parker, they said she was the wittiest woman in New York. And one of her friends said she can say something funny about absolutely anything. She said, I think I've got a subject that I don't think she can say anything funny about.
horticulture. And Dorothy Parker said, when you can lead a horticulture, but you can't make her think. I don't know if I'm up to doing this, but I'll give it my best shot. Oh yes, I love it. Still dining out. We're standing on the outside. I don't know where I'm going to, but I don't know. Just one thing. There's somewhere. Stuff. I love it all. I really do. I've got one from Anthony Albanese. Yeah? The thing about Anthony Albanese is he's short, isn't he? You know? So I'd like to do this for Albanese. Short people got no reason. Short people got no reason.
got no reason to live. They got little hands, they got little eyes. They walk around telling great big lies. They got little noses, little teeth, platform shoes on nasty little feet. Well, I don't want no short people helping out. I don't want no short people. I don't want no short people around here. But short people are just the same as you and I. Fools such as I. All men are brothers until the day we die. And it's a wonderful world with short people got nobody. Short people got nobody. Short people got nobody to vote for them. They got little baby legs, stand so low. You got to pick them up just to say hello. They got little voices that go peep, peep, peep. And little cars that go beep, beep, beep. They got grubby little fingers, dirty little minds. They gonna get you every time. And I don't want no short people. I don't want no short people. I don't want no short people around here. Not around here. He's gotta be short on votes too. So much stuff here that I love.
Somebody loves him.
What's that?
Somebody loves him.
Yeah. Yeah. Mate, I don't think his mother even loves him anymore. Yeah. No, look, he's... Oh, it's okay. Look, he's done us a favour. He's bought us $360 billion worth of submarines. I mean, look on the bright side, you know? We have all these submarines. Do you like the Beatles?
Yes.
You want a slow one or a fast one? Anyway, gonna dance?
Yes.
Come on, my favorite song. Here we go. Where is it? Well, my heart went as I
Since I saw her standing there, oh, since I saw her standing there. I got a beauty, but I don't know what this is. This is a killer. I love this one. Yeah. Buy you diamonds, make my friend, if it makes you feel alright. I give you anything, my friend, if it makes you feel alright. I don't care two marks for money, I'm on a camp, I'm in love. I give you all I have to give, if you say you love me too. I have a lot to give, but what I got, I'll give to you. I don't care too much for money, I'm out of camp, I'm in love, can't buy love. Everybody tell me something, can't buy me love. No. Say you don't need no doubt of me. Tell me what the kind of things money just can't buy. That's what we're here. Money can't buy me love. Yeah. Yeah. Can't buy me love. Everybody tell me so. Can't buy me love. No. Say you don't need no diamond ring, now be satisfied. Tell me what the kind of things that money just can't buy. But I don't care too much for money, the money can't buy me love, can't buy me love. This is another one for the government. It's called I Can't Get No Satisfaction. Yes. Yeah, where is it? No, that's not it. Just for that first time. I don't know where. I got 150 songs in here. They all are. It's worth waiting for because it's a good one. I love this one.
I'm out of cigarettes. Anybody got a cigarette?
Someone needs a lung killer. But where was it? Oh, that's no good. No, that's no good. Here's another one. This will do for the minute.
Desmond has his gown in the marketplace. Molly used to sing her in the band. Desmond said to Molly, girl, I like your face. And as he says it to her, takes her by the hand. I'm blinding, I'm blinding, life goes on. Life goes on. I'm blinding, I'm blinding, life goes on. Now what did you guess? We took his barrel to the jeweler's store and buys a 20 carat golden ring. He takes it back to Molly when he met the door. She said, it's not big enough. I'm lucky, I'm lucky, life goes on. Life goes on. I'm lucky, I'm lucky, life goes on. Goes on. couple of years, day I felt a home sweet home. With a couple of kids running in the yard, Desmond and Mommy Joe, and happy ever after in the marketplace. Mommy lets the children in the hand. Desmond stays at home and puts his pretty face, and in the evening he's a singer in the band. Come on! I'm lucky, I'm lucky, I've got time. A couple of kids running in the yard, Desmond and Bobby Joe. One more. Happy ever after in the marketplace, Molly lets the children in the hand. Desmond stays at home and does his pretty face, and in the evening he's a singer in the band. It's who she's thinking of, and she told me what to say. She said she loves you, and no man can be bad. She said she loves you, and you know you should be glad. She said you heard a song where she almost lost her mind. And now she says she knows that you're not the one. No, that can't be bad. She loves you, and you know you should sure be glad. Gotta help me here. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, with a love like that, you know you should be glad. You know it's up to you. Well, I think it's only fair. I can't hurt you too, so apologize to her, because she loves you, and you know that can't be bad. She loves you, and you know you should be glad. Oh. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. With a love like that, you know you should be glad. And a love like that, you know you should be glad. And with a love like that, you know you should be glad. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's it, folks. Thank you very much. Very nice to meet my fellow travelers. Thank you.
Beautiful, thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? No? Yes?